Goldberg with his sights firmly set on Rick Steiner at Road Wild 1 week from this Saturday. In his path, the public enemy, Flyboy Rocco Rock, his opponent tonight on Thunder, and Johnny Grunge in the corner. Goldberg, since his return to World Championship Wrestling, he came back at the Georgia Dome on the 5th of July. And the past several weeks, he's been back, and Goldberg in-ring competition looks stronger than ever. Everyone in the WCW locker room on notice because the man is back.
Hey, the man is back. Everybody on notice. I think a lot of guys starting to get jealous. Everybody wants to beat Goldberg's record. Get the electricity in the buildings Goldberg's getting. I tell you, I don't think anybody can do it, not even a man who wants to be the next millennium man. I think you're looking at the man of the next century. And I'm not talking about Rocco.
Well, we heard Monday on Nitro as well as earlier tonight from psychotic Sid Vicious, who claims to be the millennium man, the man of the year 2000. And Sid Vicious insists that he will eclipse the previous winning streak of Goldberg. Good luck, Sid.
Yeah, maybe on the dark side of the moon.
Goldberg just stalking Flyboy Rocco Rock. And this crowd in La Crosse, Wisconsin shows their support for the man. You see Goldberg motioning to the crowd. He feels it's just a matter of time until he regains the gold of the World's Heavyweight Championship belt.
I've never seen a man this size with the balance that's as strong and as explosive as Goldberg. I mean, some guys are strong, but Goldberg can use that strength better than I've seen everybody. I mean, just explodes into people.
Phenomenal strength by Goldberg.
Look at the
shove Rocco Rock off and then put the shoulder to Rocco Rock. Flyboy off the ropes. Look at this.
He's got the balance right here. He's got the power.
That's the Goldberg press slam. And he drives Rocco, and then Johnny Grunge interferes.
Couldn't take it.
Another shoulder. Down goes Rocco Rock, and both members of Public Enemy roll out to the floor to stop this offensive assault.
I mean, running into Goldberg is like hitting an oak tree. I mean, Rocco just, he's not approaching this right at all, but then again, there's not a right way to approach Goldberg. You're in trouble when they ring the bell.
And the Public Enemy have decided to slow down Goldberg. They remain outside the ring while Goldberg just waits his prey in the middle of the squared circle.
It'd be tough to beat the Goldberg piece of cardboard. That looks strong.
Again, they lock it up, collar and elbow. And Goldberg, the pure raw strength, just muscling Rocco Rock into the corner. Oh, Rocco Rock out of the corner. You know, he's got a boxing background. Caught him with a pair of right hands, and then Goldberg just throttles him around the throat and brings him out to the middle of the ring.
Hey, this isn't fisticuffs, brother. This is brutal.
Goldberg follows up his advantage in the corner. Boot to the midsection. Oh, with impact, he fired Rocco Rock off into the turnbuckles.
And Goldberg's just kind of maneuvering around. It's almost a warm-up match for him. He just taking his sweet time, and Rocco's going flying.
Off the knee to the midsection, Rocco Rock ducks the clothesline. Attempted a flying cross body block.
Wrong move.
I think you're right. Goldberg just toying with one half of the Public Enemy and drives Rocco to the canvas. The look on the face of Goldberg tells it all. The intensity, and now he's got his sights on Johnny Grunge. Look, there's a chair in the ring. I believe Johnny Grunge just passed in a chair to Rocco.
He's trying to distract Goldberg away from that chair.
Johnny Grunge up on the ring apron. It's exactly what he's done. He's distracted him, and Flyboy's got the steel chair. Oh, he just nailed Goldberg to the back, and the whiplash effect is Goldberg's throat made contact with that top steel cable. Now they double team Goldberg, take him up into the air and drive him down to the mat. Referee Mickey J trying to get his senses and trying to get his sight back.
I think he got an elbow in the eye or the face or something.
Rocco Rock again with the chair to the back of the head of Goldberg. Public Enemy brings the table into the ring. They're gonna stack the table up, or they're gonna open it up. They've stacked it in the corner.
I don't know,
look out, Goldberg's on his feet.
It doesn't matter.
Public Enemy, look out! He just caught him with a double spear and put both members of Public Enemy through the table.
That Public Enemy asked for it. They brought it in. Goldberg served up something on the table. It was those buffet they weren't counting on.
The legal man is Flyboy Rocco Rock, but it may not matter. After the spear, he's going to take him up.
The legal man may be Rocco. The unconscious man is Johnny Grunge.
There's the jackhammer from Goldberg. Two and three. The count is academic.
Academic? I don't even think Goldberg broke a sweat.
He certainly broke the table in half with both members of the Public Enemy. As that spear, as he came charging across the ring, took out both Flyboy Rocco Rock and Johnny Grunge.
I tell you, Star Wars may use the Force. Goldberg is the Force, most explosive, powerful athlete within balance I've ever seen. And psychotic Sid may want to be the Millennium Man, but I think Goldberg is doing just fulfilling destiny, Mike. It's his destiny.
Bring it on is what Goldberg says. Who is going to be the man for the millennium? Goldberg staking his claim. Sid Vicious insists that he is going to be the millennium man. And this crowd in La Crosse, Wisconsin shows what they feel for the man himself, Goldberg. Larry, we're going to take another look. Let's go to the replay. Goldberg so dominant.
After the fact, man, Goldberg just dove, exploded spear, not only Rocco Rock, Johnny Grunge, a table Grunge was out cold. Rocco, the legal man, what was left of him, held up high and just, man, smacked right through that bat, pulled up the leg. It was academic. The next century belongs to Goldberg.
Goldberg, the man. We'll see you Saturday night on TBS. And don't forget, Randy Savage has the surprise announcements Monday on Nitro.